Hello and welcome to After Before Friday week number 40. This week I'm working on a photo of my 15-year-old Min Pin named Brandy, who likes to sit behind me, tucked behind me in my office chair. So I thought, and I took this at Christmas time, and I thought it would be a fun picture to work on today. I'm going to do this all in Lightroom, so I'm going to start off by coming into the basics panel, and the first thing I'm going to do, because it's underexposed, is to increase the exposure. I'm going to bring it up to about here, and then I'm going to crank down the highlights, and I'm going to open the shadows. Minus 100 and plus 100. This is a new method I've learned, so I've been playing around with this. I'm also going to bump up the whites. Looking at my histogram, I can bring it up. And if you hold down your option key, again, that trick, you can see when a white point enters your photo. So I'm going to leave it there. And the same with the blacks. Hold down your option key, drag your slider, and when you start to see color in your photo, then you've hit a black point. So I'm going to leave it about there. And then I'm going to boost the clarity just a bit, about five points. Now at this point, my basics have been done, but I want to really focus attention on Brandy. So I'm going to do this with a combination of filters. The graduated filter I'm going to begin with, and I want to tone down this brightness of, that's the Christmas tree in the back, and I will use that. I will use the graduated filter to do so. So I will click and hold on my mouse, left hand, and I'm going to bring it down to about here. And you can change the angle of the filter by clicking and holding and dragging out here on the middle line. So I'm going to leave this about here. And I'm going to, let's see, decrease the exposure for this. And I see that saturation has been checked already. Double check, double click on effect to zero out all your sliders before you begin making adjustments. So I'm going to bring down the exposure to about here. And then I'm going also to decrease the shadows or increase the shadows to about here, okay? And now, and then I'm going to click done for this one. I'm also going to add a graduated filter in the bottom left-hand corner, and I am going to bring this up to about here, and then I'm going to decrease the exposure again, and see, here we go. For some reason, saturation is being loaded into the filter, so double-click on effect to zero everything out. And then I'm going to bring down the exposure here because nobody's really interested in the underside of my chair, just to about here. Okay, and click done. The next thing I want to do is to add a radial filter around Brandy's head to help focus attention here, more attention here. And if you hold down the shift key while you click and hold down on your mouse, you will get a perfect circle. So I'm going to, continue to draw. Well, okay, let's go back. And I'm going to enlarge this a bit more. There we go. And to reposition the filter, you just hold and click and hold on the middle pin, and you can move it wherever you want. This is where I want for Brandy. And I'm going to use a preset in my radial filter in my local adjustment brushes. And this is presets that I have actually purchased. You can create your own, but some of these presets are pretty involved, so it's nice to have them here. And I'm going to use something called preset, the basic correction slight. And you'll see what the parameters are for it. It decreases highlights, it opens up the shadows, and it increases the sharpness. So I can show you this before and after. It's slight, and the one thing about this preset that I don't like is that it has a tint, a magenta tint, so I'm going to pull that down. So there we go. I will show you again before and after. I don't know if you can see it on your screen, but on mine it's very subtle, but it just pops Brandy a little bit more. Okay, I'm going to click done here. The next thing I'm going to do is because Brandy is off-center, using a vignette that Lightroom has in the effects tab is not easy. Brandy's off center, so I oftentimes create vignettes using the radial filters. I'm going to click on it, and this time I am going to create an oval vignette. So I'm just going to drag, and then to adjust it, and I want to skew it so that it lines up with Brandy. You can see you just put your mouse out here until those little points come up and you see that arrow, and you just hold and you move. And then you can increase the shape. And I can already tell without even looking at my panel that the saturation, once again, is preset, as is the is preloaded. So again, zero out by clicking on effect. And on this one, I'm just, and I want to create the vignette, so I want the effect to be on the outside of the radial filter. So I'm going to uncheck invert mask, and then I'm going to just simply decrease the shadows. It's not by much, but just enough. Right about there. Okay, then I'm going to click done. And then I'm going to come in, and there's a preset that on the adjustment and the adjustment local adjustments called Iris Enhance. And I'm going to use that on Brandy's eyes just to bring a bit more focus to them. So I'm going to reduce the size of my brush by using the scroll wheel on my mouse and click on her eye. And I'm going to paint in. If you come down here and click on Show Selected Mask Overlay, and I'm actually going to move in, then you can see where you've painted. Oh, look at all that noise. Well, that's something that I will be dealing with next. I'm going to increase my brush size. So paint in her eyes, and if you go over, which I have, hit the Option key to make it into an eraser, hit and hold it down, and you can go back in and fix that. So let's come over to this eye. Okay, and I'm going to zoom back out. I'm going to uncheck the mask overlay, and I'm going to hit done and see what it looks like. And I know in my original, I toned this down just a bit. So let's come back. I didn't want it to look too unrealistic. So I'm going to bring the exposure down, oops, where is it, just slightly. Okay, so it's just a little bit. Okay, and let's see, sharpening, I don't know if this has been, it may be in there, yep, my sharpening, I'm going to come over and use Sharpen Faces, a preset that is in Lightroom. Okay, we'll bring that up. And then I'm also going to come in, because you can see the noise that's in the photo. I'm going to do a little bit of noise reduction. So I'm going to bring the luminance slider over to about here. Whoops, that popped up. And then to add just a little bit of detail back in, I'm going to bump that up. So it does a pretty good job with dealing with the noise in this photo. Last, I'm going to crop it, and I'm going to come into the crop overlay, and I'm going to come down and use the golden ratio number, more panoramic view. I don't need all of this background in here. And you'll see it's already set to the triangles overlay. You can get to the different overlays by hitting O on your keyboard, and it will cycle through the various overlays that you might want to use. I tend to use the triangle overlay a lot, and if when you're scrolling through you hit Shift and O, then you can, it will give you different orientations of the same overlay. And for this, you try and get your focal points or main focal points within one of the triangles. So Brandy's face certainly is in the bottom triangle, and the lesser points are in the other. So I'm going to click done. And that is the finished product. So I'm going to come back to the beginning. This was on import. Okay. And after the initial bump up in exposure, so we went from there to here. And as I look at that, I'm actually going to come in and I'm going to decrease the saturation just a bit because she's looking a little orange. So I think that's better. Let's go back and see. Yeah, I don't know how that happened. I'm going to come back and look again. I mean, she is orange, but not overly so. So there you go. Okay. That's where I'm going to leave my dear Brandy. So I hope you've enjoyed the photo. If you have any comments, please feel free to leave them on my blog, or if you're looking at this on YouTube, on my YouTube page. And if you want to see any more examples of after before photos and their galleries, please visit visualventuring.com and look for After Before Friday Forum. Thanks everybody for watching.